गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ योर इंग्लिश टीचर मनोज कुमार वर्मा. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू सम लिटरेरी डिवाइसेस फॉर क्लास 10 स्टूडेंट्स. सो सम लिटरेरी डिवाइसेस देर आर लॉट ऑफ लिटरेरी डिवाइसेस, बट अमंग सम ऑफ द सिलेक्टेड लिटरेरी डिवाइस आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे. फर्स्ट, सिमली. सिमली इज एन एक्सप्रेस्ड कंपेरिजन बिटवीन टू थिंग्स ऑफ अनलाइक नेचर. Like or as is used to indicate simile. For example, moon is broken like a mirror. So mirror is comparing with moon by using like here. So it is simile. Second literary device is metaphor. Metaphor is an implied comparison between two things of unlike nature. Like and as are omitted in metaphor. For example, the fog comes on little cat feet. Here, little cat feet is comparing with fog without using like or as. So it is metaphor. Next literary device is personification. Personification gives to animal, to inanimate object, or to abstract ideas the character of a person. Okay, so when inanimate thing is presented as a human being, this is called personification. So personification, for example, wind rushed to meet them. So wind is just representing over here as a human being. So it is personification. Next literary device is hyperbole. Hyperbole is an obvious exaggeration. For example, the growing boy's hand dangled a mile out of his lips. So it is exaggerated. This sentence is exaggerated over here. Next literary device I am going to teach you, that is irony. So irony lies in an event that is contrary to what the reader expects or what is the truth. So there is different in expectation and truth. So this is called irony. For example, God, of the mercy money that I asked for, only 70 pesos reach me. Send me the rest, since I need it very much, but don't send it to me through the mail, because the post office employees are a bunch of crook. In this sentence, you are looking that there is an irony. Irony. So whoever is sending money, it is man, but he is expecting to be a god. So this is irony. Very nice irony is derived from your first lesson from first flight book, the letter to God. Next literary device is alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of a letter or a sound at the beginning of a succession of word. That is called alliteration. Stop that slouching and sit up straight. This is here, the S sound is repeated in this sentence. So this is very nice example taken from Amanda. This is very good example from this chapter. Onomatopoeia is the use of sound that suggests the meaning of the word, like flopped, buzzed. This is the sound produced in the nature, that is called onomatopoeia. Next is apostrophe. Apostrophe is used when the poet addresses the poem to someone who is absent, like for example, that only God, my dear, second, could love you for yourself alone. Okay, here the God is just addressing to my dear. Next is epithet. Epithet is a coupling of an adjective with a noun so that one use suggests the other. Like that, the violent mob is just like as an adjective is qualifying to a word. So this is the literary device. Many more literary devices are there in English. In the next video, I will discuss the another literary devices also. Till then, thank you. Thank you very much, my dear student. Hope this video is very fruitful and useful to you.